church, we commonly say that you are being ordained to the transitional diaconate. But that is a bit of a misnomer. The diaconate is not just a stepping stone to the presbyteral order. You are not receiving a bachelor's degree in anticipation of a master's degree. You are not stepping on the mezzanine floor before going to the top floor. Instead, I would ask you to see the permanency of your diaconal ministry, fully and completely ordained as a deacon to serve the church in the name of Jesus Christ, the servant of God. You will never leave behind your diaconal ministry. You will carry it forward to be incorporated into your priestly ministry. The humble servant of God characterizes the priest as shepherd in the name of Jesus, the good shepherd and head of the church. The priest continues to wait on tables. The pastor washes the feet of the disciples after the manner of Jesus. So what we say today about the deacon is permanent and must be integrated into your priestly ministry and expanded, so to speak, in your service as a priest. As a deacon, you will preach the word of God, you will baptize, you will serve at the altar, you will preside at marriages, you will bury the dead. And in a most significant way, you will be a spiritual leader the church's ministry of charity and justice, bringing the love of Christ to the most needy and vulnerable, especially those who are excluded by reason of race, the economy, unemployment, or other unjust social discriminations. You may have already radio this morning about our Holy Father, Pope Francis, going to Lesbos to meet with all the refugees and going there as a sign to the world, reaching out in care to those who are in these most desperate situations. And there he was joined by the ecumenical patriarch Bartholomew. And then the Holy Father, it is recorded, brought back three Syrian families to the Vatican for resettlement. Diaconal ministry, the life and ministry of our Holy Father. When you preach the Word of God, when you celebrate the sacraments, when you perform works of charity, when you act for justice, you will meet people in the widest variety of situations, including members of the church who participate, as Pope Francis says, in her life in an incomplete manner. I would like to suggest today that the ministry of the deacon is the ministry of the construction worker. You have indeed been chosen by God to go and bear fruit. That's an agricultural cultural metaphor, that you have been chosen to go and bear fruit that will remain. Jesus says this in John's Gospel. But if I may be so bold, I would put forward today as a metaphor for our world that of a construction worker, helping people to build their lives or to rebuild their lives in the way of God. No matter who you serve, whether in sacramental ministry or in social ministry, you bring the healing mercy of God, which invites conversion and a renewal of life and restores one's dignity by God's grace. You leave behind any harsh or hasty judgments, and you proceed to accompany people in reconstructing their lives to live more fully as human beings and as children of God. The way of Christ is the way of God's mercy, which leads to salvation. The way of Christ is that of laying down one's life for one's friend. You serve God by accompanying people on the journey of life, by offering them the love of God, the message of the gospel, and the hope of eternal life. What you do as a deacon, you will do more fully as a priest in celebrating the Eucharist and in presiding over the care of the church. But it is the same Christ who is the good shepherd, the head of the church, servant of God. You will always be a deacon, even in your priestly ministry. May you build houses that are well constructed and will last through all kinds of storms. May your hearts be filled with the love which cares deeply for all those you serve. May you follow Christ, the servant, as a deacon, as a priest,